He was gunned down in his prime at a busy Las Vegas intersection with hundreds of witnesses. Why was the shooter never ID'd? Number four, Tupac Shakur.
I mean, that case scares the crap out of everybody involved. In fact, the people involved are the ones who understand retaliation probably better than anybody else.
You had a guy who was an icon in the music industry, one of the greatest rappers, who got killed senselessly.
In the world of rap music, no star burned brighter than Tupac Shakur.
Well, you know, Tupac represents not only, you know, a controversial figure, but Tupac is somebody who's complex, both volatile and also radical.
What we're doing is using our brain to get out of the ghetto any way we can. So we tell these stories, you know what I'm saying? And they tend to be violent.
On September 7th, 1996, Tupac and his manager, Death Row Records president Marion Suge Knight, left the MGM Hotel in Las Vegas after watching a Mike Tyson fight. Suge led a procession of luxury vehicles on their way to a nightclub. His only passenger was Tupac Shakur. Suge's BMW stopped at the corner of East Flamingo Road and Koval Lane, an intersection that was about to become an infamous crime scene.
There was another car that pulled up alongside them, and some individuals began firing at the car, hitting Tupac several times. Suge Knight, I believe, got grazed, and Tupac went to the hospital.
The shooter sped around the corner and disappeared into the chaos of the Las Vegas Strip, never to be seen again. Tupac died 7 days later.
Yeah, 10 vans full of guys when Tupac got shot. None of them came forward. These are not the people that go, hey, let me tell you what I saw.
You know, frankly, you come forward, there's no guarantee you're going to be around long enough to be a witness in the case.
LA gang unit cops quickly pointed the finger at a man Tupac and Suge had confronted earlier that night, a known LA gang member named Orlando Anderson. Anderson was never formally charged with the crime. He was gunned down 2 years later at a Compton car wash.
Well, a rapper-on-rapper killing is a lot like other gang killings, which is, you know, those witnesses don't want to come forward either. They'd rather deal with it in their own way. At some point, they'll bring their own type of justice. They don't even trust the system.
To this day, those who know who killed Tupac aren't talking.
It is a misconception when cases are unsolved that the police don't know who did it. A lot of times they do know who did it, and they just don't have enough evidence to arrest them.